Hi, I'm Courtney, and together with my husband Steve, we are a Stream in Life. We travel full-time in our 30-foot Airstream around the country. And today, I'm going to talk about how to find water and dump stations when you're boondocking. So first, what do I mean by boondocking? In this case, I'm talking about camping somewhere out in the wilderness with no hookups, therefore no water and no dump stations. So after we've been doing this for a week, obviously you're gonna need to get more water at some point. You're also going to need to dump your tanks. So how do you find where to do that? Let me give you our tips. We'll start with water. Some dump stations will have potable water. So when I talk about dump stations, I'll get to that in a minute. Other than that, you can find water in a number of different ways. If you are camping near a national park, they will often have water in the national park. And if you are going in and paying the fee or using your pass to get in anyway, you can always fill up at water stations there. We've done that a couple of times, Bryce being one of the ones that sticks in my mind because they had easy water access at one of the main parking trailhead areas. State parks sometimes also have this. So if you're going to a state park, you pay the fee to get in anyway, you can fill up some water there to bring back to your trailer and siphon in. We've even seen this at national forest trailheads. That's much harder to research beforehand. That was more of a we stumbled across it, but I'm sure that you could find it somewhere. But just know that sometimes in some trailheads, they will have water, especially if it's a picnic area and they have bathrooms and they expect people to hang out and enjoy the area, can find water. You can also sometimes find free water in certain towns, especially towns that are the headwaters of rivers. For instance, Mount Shasta up in the mountains had a free water source because it's the headwaters of the Sacramento River. So that was an easy place to find water as well. Last resort, or I guess it's not last resort, but another resort is to find glacier water dispensers. We've found them at different grocery stores in different towns where we were having a hard time finding water. You can always pay to get water through a dispenser, one of the glacier water dispensers or something like that. Now, dump stations. Like I said, some dump stations will have potable water, but you need to be careful that it is potable water and not just rinse water to rinse out your sore hose. Some will have it, some will not. How do you know? Some will say it when you call or when you look online, but others won't. And so it can be a toss-up. It is really nice to find, if you have to pay for a dump station, to find one that has potable water as well. It makes everything much easier because then you can just fill your tanks and not have to worry about siphoning water and everything like that. So we're talking about dump stations. The way that we find dump stations the most are through a few different websites and applications. The first is our AllStays app, which we use for a number of different things, including finding camping sometimes, looking at routes to see if they have bad grades or turns or anything we need to know about. But they also show dump stations. And they'll even show if a campground has a dump station and if they have listed that they will allow other people to use it. So first, just plain old dump stations. They show them as a blue symbol, which is often what you see on the roads on signs too, especially here in Idaho. So for instance, this is a visitor center that has a dump station. It's $5. It has water and it has 4 dump receptacles is what it says. So here it says water, so you'd assume it has potable water, hopefully, and it did. And for $5 you can dump. But you could also look at one of these other campgrounds and they may allow you to come in and use their dump station and get water for a fee. Not all campgrounds will let you do this if you're not staying with them, even if they have one. So if you don't know, I would call ahead because we've had friends show up at campgrounds that have dump stations and been turned away, even though they are willing to pay to dump their tanks. So call ahead if you're just going to a campground that hasn't already listed saying this is the fee for non-campers, for people who aren't staying there. Other ways to find dump stations. Campendium. Campendium is a great site to find camping, but they also have some dump stations listed. So I'll always check the area that we're in to see if someone has listed a dump station. In addition, if you are boondocking in an area that is listed on CampEndium or on freecampsites.net, check the reviews, because other people may have said where they went to dump, and while it may not be listed anywhere else, at least then you have an idea of a place nearby. Now, there are a number of other websites that will tell you dump stations as well. The only one that I've really used at this point is sannydumps.com, and we've used this one quite a bit recently to find dump stations, and it is quite nice. You can pick your state or your town or your region. They even have other countries besides the United States, which is kind of cool. And they will even show you on a Google map all the dump stations. So here we have a huge number of them, and they have them colored differently for free, pay for registered guests only. Again, that's only if you're staying at that campground, and multi-user fee, which is normally the ones where you pay $5 to dump and fill up with water. And they usually also list whether they have water. For instance, I just clicked on this guy. This is an RV park, free for registered guests or fee for dump station use only. So that one tells you that. And then there's this free one, but it does not say it has water. All of these are only as good as the people who put them into the website and the reviews that are listed. So keep that in mind. When we're going to a place that we've only found on one website, we're always a little bit, we don't get our hopes up, let's put it that way, that there's gonna be water or there's gonna be dump. We'll often check it out beforehand before we actually drag the trailer all the way there to dump, because we are not 100% sure that all the information we have is accurate. But looking at all of these sources, there are loads of dump stations around, and there's loads of where areas to find water as well. So really, with all of this information out there, it is not that difficult to find water and dump options when you are boondocking. So those are our tips that we have learned on how to find water and dump stations when we're boondocking. I'm sure people who've been doing this longer may have even more ideas for us, so if you do, leave them in the comments below for us and for anyone who else who would like to know. If you are interested in following our journey around the country and everything we're learning and trying and exploring, we'd love it if you subscribe to our channel, and we'll do another how-to video here soon. Thanks, guys. Bye.